To speak in this debate on local issues. Mr. Speaker, I'm based in Pekuranga, which is east of Auckland, and there is this issue that is causing a huge amount of concern to not only local people, but people, those who go through that electorate or that suburb as well. Mr. Speaker, I want to talk about the issue of speed limit reductions. Speed limit reductions were imposed by the previous Labour government, and Mr. Speaker, since those speed limit reductions, people are feeling really frustrated. And this is for several reasons. And I want to, Mr. Speaker, in the start, acknowledge that nobody wants to see any kind of harm or injury or fatal accidents happening on our roads. But Mr. Speaker, speed is just one contributing factor. And one would sit and think, well, how do we reduce those incidents happening on our roads? Well, reduce speeds, yep, one might think that is a logical thing to do, but Mr. Speaker, it is not a logical thing to do if we do not consider other factors that contribute to these incidents that happen on our roads. So, Mr. Speaker, that is a very lazy approach, I would say, Mr. Speaker, to just reduce speed and not look at the condition of the road. We also need to keep in mind that other contributing factors, as I said, condition of the road, weather conditions, condition of people's cars that they're driving, and also drivers' behaviors contribute to accidents that happen on our roads. So, Mr. Speaker, we need a comprehensive solution when we are trying to target incidents that happen on our roads. And, Mr. Speaker, we want to do things which actually improve efficiency. And, Mr. Speaker, to improve efficiency, of course, we need to look at our systems, structures, and infrastructure. But can I say this, Mr. Speaker, that this line applies only to this side of the House, because we are keen to improve efficiency, not that side. What they did, Mr. Speaker, they slowed everybody down, and obviously there is a flow-on effect on the economy of not just local area, but Auckland and the whole of our country. Mr. Speaker, time is precious. And what happened because of that change by the previous government, Labour government, people are stuck in traffic. They're just looking at their clock, ticking, 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 Mr. Speaker. 15, 20, 30 minutes added to one-way traffic, Mr. Speaker. That is hurting people at so many levels. People's personal life, people's work life are being hurt. And I'm really glad that we campaigned to reverse those speed limit reductions, and coalition government has already announced that those speed limit reductions will be reversed. Mr. Speaker, because of that, the main roads, which are Pekuranga Road, which has been dropped from 60 kilometers per hour to 50 kilometers per hour, part of Tirakau Drive, dropped from 60 kilometers per hour to 50 kilometers per hour. Botany Road, parts of that have been dropped from 60 kilometers per hour to 50 kilometers. And Tirangi Drive, which is again a very busy and important road, Mr. Speaker. There are three speed limits now, from 60 kilometers per hour to 50 kilometers per hour, 80 kilometers per hour to 50 kilometers per hour, and one part is from 80 kilometers per hour to 60 kilometers per hour. So, Mr. Speaker, with these roads becoming slower, what is happening is obviously during peak time there is more traffic, and obviously people follow GPS, so there is more traffic going on to small roads, the residential roads, creating a lot of anxiety for these people, those who live locally, because of the traffic congestion that they are seeing. And off-peak, Mr. Speaker, what this is leading to is inefficient use of road capacity. Because people see there is so much space, but they, Mr. Speaker, cannot, Mr. Speaker, use those roads to its efficient capacity. Mr. Speaker, we need to see that the speed is optimal. Optimal according to road conditions. But instead of looking at what other conditions can be improved, they just decided to slow everybody down. And Mr. Speaker, we know that in East Auckland we have had this issue of street races. When, Mr. Speaker, people do those kind of things, and yes, there was media coverage as well, and my heart goes out to those victims and the families of that victim. But, Mr. Speaker, when people adopt this kind of behavior, they're not going to change that behavior just because the speed limit has been reduced. So if somebody's racing at 160 kilometers per hour, when the speed limit is 80 kilometers per hour, it's not like if we reduce the speed limit to 50 kilometers per hour, somehow those people will start speeding at 120 kilometers per hour, because that is not how they are thinking, Mr. Speaker. So, Mr. Speaker, on this side, we want to see that things are done in efficient manner. We want to see that things are done in a speedy and also safe manner. We want to, Mr. Speaker, see progress. Not like them, Mr. Speaker, slow everything down. And that is why, Mr. Speaker, I'm really glad that this coalition government has announced that we will reverse those speed limit reductions that were imposed by the previous Labour government. Thank you.
Andy Foster.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Good local government is